What's going on, guys? Billy the Bat Boy here, and every year since 2014, I've had the opportunity to ask a question on the Yes Network's Yankees Hot Stove, hosted by the Yogi Bear Museum and Learning Center. I would like to thank the panel of Bob Lorenz, Jack Curry, John Flaherty, and Meredith Marakovitz for this opportunity, and without further ado, let's go check out my seven questions from the past 7 years.
Let's get back to another question. What do we have next?
Hi, my name is Billy Pinckney, and I was wondering, what do you think about the Yankees signing Brian McCann, Jacoby Ellsbury, and Carlos Beltran?
Well, big free agent signings in the offseason had a lot of home run potential at Yankees.
Let's go back up to the stands. What you got?
Hi, my name is Billy Pinckney from Low Falls, New Jersey, and my question is, do you think Mr. Cashman could put together a team that could compete for a championship this year?
Well, now, because you were courteous about calling him Mr. Cashman, you can just refer to him as Cash. You see Brian Cashman, Mr. Cashman, go out and make some more moves.
So he gets to call him Cash now, Billy does, and you got to
call
him
Mr. Cashman now, Billy.
All right. We got to take another break here on Yankees Hot Stove. Go up to the stands again.
Hi, my name is Billy Pinckney from Low Falls, New Jersey, and my question is, what do you think Joe Girardi's biggest challenge will be this season?
Look at the Yankees last year. Their starters averaged...
All right, let's get to our final question. Billy,
fire away. My name is Billy Pinckney from Little Falls, New Jersey, and my question is, do you think Joe Girardi can continue to motivate this exciting group of young players and aging veterans?
Billy Pinckney is here every year. He's like the fifth member of our show. We love having you here, Billy. Every year he's here when he comes to the museum. What do you think?
And Billy, to be honest with you, when you're a young player at the major league level getting an opportunity, you don't really need to be motivated. You're going to go out there trying to establish yourself. Clint Frazier wants to be great. Well, you have an opportunity to go do it.
I love the live audience. I love when they have the opportunity to ask us questions. And I just hope that our good friend, Billy the Bat Boy, Billy Pinckney, I'm going to give Billy a little shout. Look this kid up. He's already interviewed more professional athletes than people who are working for in the New York media right now.
All right, let's get to our second question. Why don't you just tell us what various social media sites you have going there, Billy? What do you got?
Hi, my name is Billy Pinckney from Little Falls, New Jersey, and my question is, do you think this young Yankees team can handle the expectations the fans have for them in 2018?
All right, Jack, you go ahead. The last show, you pumped up Billy the Bat Boy. You didn't give your website, your blog.
I have a website where I interview players, mainly baseball players, some football players. It's called BillyTheBatBoysCorner.com. I'm a bat boy with the New Jersey Jackals, so that's where I got the name from. And for the past 2.5 years, I've been interviewing athletes.
You're supposed to drop the mic now, Billy. just drop the mic. But to Billy's question about the Yankees and the expectations, I absolutely think that this bunch can handle.
All right, guys, Billy, great job. Question number three.
Audience Q&A segment. We do it every year. It's a great segment. We're going to start with question number one, and it's actually our buddy Billy Pinckney, Billy the Bat Boy. We actually have a question for you. In the future, are you taking my job or Jack's?
I'm not sure. Whatever one is available.
Oh, great. I'm keeping the options open. How about this one? Wrong answer. Security. Anyway, Billy, go ahead. What's your question?
My name is Billy Pinckney from Little Falls, New Jersey, and my question is, the Yankees currently have a starting rotation consisting of young and older veterans. Do you think at some point during the season Aaron Boone would consider a six-man rotation?
And just say, have six guys in the rotation. So
we're going to start by going up into the audience by a guy that needs no introduction because we know him from every year. It's Billy Pinckney. By the way, he's Billy the Bat Boy. We can't really call him Billy the Bat Boy anymore, right?
No, he's upped his game. He's Billy the talent procurer now for the New Jersey Jackals. He's hunting down talent for a professional sports team.
I know, plus we've seen him grow up, so you're like Billy the Bat Dude now. Anyway, Billy, what are you doing now, by the way?
Right, so I'm currently the player procurement assistant with the New Jersey Jackals, as well as press box assistant, and I've been doing a lot of media stuff with them. Found about 10 players this past season, and we won the championship, so it's a great season.
Congratulations, that's awesome. Yeah. So what...
My question is, looks like the Yankees lineup will only consist of a couple left-handed batters. Is that something of concern for the Yankees?
Flash, what about you? What do you think about that?
I don't think so, Billy. You talk about all these right-handed hitters in the lineup, but they're right-handed hitters who drive the ball out to right field. Aaron Judge, Stanton when he's right, Luke Voigt does it, LeMahieu does it. So I think when they look at a lineup, obviously you'd like that balance with a few more lefties in there, but they always come up with a lineup that plays well at Yankee Stadium. And when you have those right-handed hitters with power that can drive it to the short porch, I don't think it's going to be an issue.